We're now analyzing how the taxes work in WooCommerce. So we're under WooCommerce Settings Tax tab. As you can see, there is a sub-tab called Tax Options. All these tabs wouldn't show if under General, and we talked about that already in a previous lesson. So if under General, these tax rates and calculations were disabled, okay? So you wouldn't find a tax tab. Thankfully, we've enabled it. So we can see these extra options. So the very first thing that you need to decide is whether the prices that you've defined for your products include or exclude tax. What does that mean? In this case, I've set this product as $33. So do I have to add tax on top of it, or does this 33 include tax? Well, in this case, you will have to decide which one is the option. This is very, very important. It strictly depends on your business model, the way you price things, and your end customers. So maybe if it is a business to business, usually prices exclude tax. And while if it is a B2C, so you're selling to customers, usually this price includes tax. But, it really depends on your e-commerce specific business. What I want to show you is no matter what you set in here, products out of the box under product data general tab will have a tax status of taxable and a tax class of standard. Okay, so by default, products are all taxable and products take the standard tax class. The standard tax class, as you can see, is comes out of the box with WooCommerce, while you can even define additional tax classes yourself. So as you can see, you can basically change the behavior on a per product basis by changing the tax class. For example, this could be a product that takes the standard rates, or this could be a product, for example, it's a teaching service that takes a zero rate tax class. And in this case, this specific product will not take any tax. This drop down here for tax classes reads basically what you have in here, and each tax class will have its own specific tab where you can define the rates. Of course, if you delete these tax classes and you go and save changes, then the tabs will vanish from here. And if you go and refresh the product, you probably have only the standard option available. So it is important in this lesson that you decide whether products prices include or exclude tax, and whether you need additional tax classes on top of the standard rates that you will define in the next lessons to make sure that each product is unique. Of course, if all your products are taxable and all your products will always and ever use only one tax class, then I recommend to avoid problems that you delete all the extra tax classes so that you don't create confusion.